I'm a contract GIS technician for the U.S. Forest Service on the El Dorado National Forest in Placerville, California. And I'm also a recent graduate of the Portland Community College GIS Certificate Program.
I use GIS in consulting to deliver GIS solutions for utilities, architecture, construction, and engineering companies.
I work for the power company here in the Pacific Northwest. In our company, the GIS department is in charge of keeping the network grid updated.
I use GIS to manage the district's geospatial data. This includes nearly 100 facilities, site assets, floor plans, and school attendance boundaries.
I use GIS in my profession by digitizing and uploading transit information onto Google Maps.
I got a GIS certification at PCC to apply to my work in environmental conservation. I use GIS for a Fulbright grant project mapping endangered Wemul deer in Chile and the threats they face in protected areas, and am now pursuing a PhD in conservation science using GIS to map the world's last wild places and assess their carbon, biodiversity, and remoteness.
First, we gather information from an agency, such as a local government, and what we look for primarily is a bus schedule, as well as a map of all of their bus routes. From there, we start the process of digitizing by first using remote sensing tools such as Google Earth and Google Street View to be able to specify the location of each of those bus stops that will be serviced. Once we have those points labeled, we are then able to align all of those bus stops and create what we call a stop pattern. A stop pattern is a bus's trip from start to finish, displaying every stop that it services on the way. Once we have a stop pattern created, we can then create a time pattern. And with a time pattern, we can add specific information such as arrival times that the bus goes to at all those stops. After we have that information set, we can then create start times for all of those trips. And from there, we have a fully digitized bus schedule. Once we have that information set, we can then start uploading that information into Google, where their riders have access to that information whenever they need it.
In order to comply with post-COVID school reentry guidelines, we're developing a custodial survey app using the brand new Esri Field Maps app. Our head custodians will collect and submit cleaning data at school sites each morning. This will allow the district to share facility cleaning data with the public when students are able to return to school. I also manage the district's ArcGIS Enterprise portal and servers, create web maps and mobile apps, including the PPS School Finder on ArcGIS Online. I'm very fortunate to be able to put my GIS skills to work to develop tools that will help decision makers, school administrators, educators, and parents.
I want to tell you about three main technologies that are key for a successful GIS career. The first one is drone technology. Learning basic concepts, operations, and applications are very important for this revolutionary industry. The second one is remote sensing. Learning how to do data acquisitions, analysis, and image interpretation are highly demanded skills nowadays. And finally, programming. Learning how to automate tasks or create programs for a specific need are skills that we should all have. Python is the most popular language used in the GIS industry. Having all of these competences are a game changer.
This summer, I had an internship with Ocean Sky Consulting, a Colorado-based firm that is a silver-level Esri partner. The focus of my internship was to set up a test-based deployment of ArcGIS Enterprise and Portal for ArcGIS in the cloud using Amazon Web Services. The purpose was to exhibit software functionality to future clients. The project required a good deal of troubleshooting, referencing Esri documentation, and corresponding with Esri support staff. I researched the AWS platform's pay-as-you-go model, Elastic Cloud Compute virtual machines, SSL certificates, and deployment options. We used the graphical user interface of ArcGIS Enterprise Cloud Builder for AWS to configure and launch the deployment. Once complete, I acted as the administrator for the company server and portal and created users. It was a challenging and fascinating project.
There's a big centralization of Forest Service corporate data going on right now, where the Forest Service is trying to get all the regional data into the corporate database. And in order to do that, all of the data has to be up to date and correct. And so what I do is I analyze corporate data, centralized Forest Service data with regional data, and find any inconsistencies between the two, flesh out, figure out which one is the correct data set according to the data stewards on the forest, be it a civil engineer or a trails coordinator, and then make sure that the proper data gets into the corporate data system smoothly. I hope that you all find success in GIS and have a great time with the program.